Hello, my name is Julian Luchek. I'm a distinguished systems engineer at Juniper Networks. Today I'd like to talk to you about SRv6 and SRm6. Both of these segment routing schemes allow you to do traffic engineering and also allow you to do service function chaining. Let's have a look at how these schemes work. In this diagram, we have traffic coming in from the left into node A and then passing into node B. When the traffic gets to node B, we want it to pass into node C. Node C has a service function associated with it. Then the traffic goes into D and arrives at E. When the traffic gets to E, we want it to pass through F rather than G. And so F is a traffic engineering stop in terms of the SRv6 processing. And finally, the traffic arrives at node H, where there's also some VNF processing occurring there. And so overall, the dots that are color-coded are the SRv6 processing nodes. Now, what happens with SRv6 is that you have a SID associated with each of these SRv6 nodes. And each of those SIDs is actually 128 bits wide. It's in the form of an IP version 6 address. If we look at SID C in a bit more detail, SID C, as I mentioned, is doing some VNF processing. And so that SID is actually in two parts. The first X bits are actually the locator of node C itself. That's how the traffic reaches node C in the first place. And then the final bits are instructions for the VNF function associated with node C. This might be a video codec or might be parental controls. And so there'll be parts of the SIDs carrying instructions for that particular function. Now, there are some well-known problems with SRv6. First of all, the SIDs are very large. As you saw, there are 128 bits. And so that gives a very large bandwidth overhead. If you take your typical internet packet size of 500 or 600 bytes, and if you had 8 SIDs in your stack, that would mean an overhead of about 20%. So if you had a 100 gigabit per second link, that means that 20 gigabits per second of that traffic are just pure IP version 6 packet headers. If you think about the days of ATM, people used to complain that ATM had an overhead of 10%. And so SRv6, in my example, is twice as bad as that in terms of bandwidth overhead. Another problem, which is equally an issue, is the fact that instructions for VNF are mixed up with the SID, which is locating the node in itself. And so what that means is that you're overloading the IP version 6 address semantics. You have this SID that appears to be an IP version 6 address, but is actually doing some other things. I think if people were to attempt to deploy this, they'd discover gradually all sorts of things that have been broken with the IP version 6 architecture. For example, what would happen if you attempted to ping one of these things that looks like an IP version 6 address? And so therefore, SRm6 was created in order to address these problems. So let's have a look at what SRm6 consists of. First of all, you can have shorter SIDs. These can be 16 bits or 32 bits instead of 128 bits. So they're much more bandwidth efficient. So you can see these much shorter SIDs here for the various SR hops along this chain. The other thing is that we move the VNF instructions into a segment endpoint option to give a clean separation between SIDs and VNF instructions. And so that means we're only taking up space for VNF instructions that actually exist, i.e. corresponding to nodes C and H in our example that are actually doing VNF processing. Furthermore, if you want, you can authenticate those VNF instructions so you know that they haven't been tampered with en route. So what are the benefits of SRm6 over SRv6? First of all, we saw that SRm6 is much more bandwidth efficient, and also it means that an ASIC can process that many more SIDs. Also, you saw that we have a clean separation between SIDs and VNF instructions, and furthermore, you can choose to authenticate those instructions if you need to. So finally, if you'd like to learn more about segment routing, come and visit us at juniper.net/sr.